I get robbed a lot. I do. I get mugged about 3 times a year. That's my average. And it's weird. Like, I don't know why I get mugged as often as I do. Like, if I had to guess, it's probably because I have a bitch face, right? Like, I'm aware. I'm cool with it. I see it every day in the mirror. I don't know if any robbers are here tonight, but you're probably looking at my face like, I could take that bitch's money. And you're right. It's super easy. You just have to ask with a stern tone of voice. And I'm like, oh, yes, yes, here, here. No joke, I've been mugged like 12 times in my life, and I think 9 out of those 12 times, I've also been really high. And I don't know if anyone here's ever been mugged when they were high, but that shit is confusing. Because when you get robbed when you're high, while it's happening, you're not even positive if you're getting robbed or if you're just handing a stranger money because you've misinterpreted social norms. The best example of this was I went to college in Boston, right? And I don't want to sound like an asshole, but you guys have heard of Harvard, right? Harvard University. It's a really good school. It's really hard to get into. So anyway, I went to Emerson College. It's like down the street from Harvard. I lived in a very bad neighborhood in Boston called Mission Hill, very violent area. And the way I coped with that is I just stayed in my apartment all day long and smoked weed and watched movies. So it was my sophomore year. I had to have been stoned because I distinctly remember watching the movie Legend on DVD, which is a Tom Cruise movie from the 80s about unicorns. The whole movie is about unicorns. So needless to say, I just plowed pussy in college, right? So yeah, my unicorn movie ended. And I looked at my roommate, Andre, and I was like, dude, I'm so hungry right now. Let's get some food. And he was like, yo, let's get pizza. And I was like, dude, that you're a genius. That's why we're friends. And we put on our boots and our jackets, and we went outside, and we walked a mile through the snow to Domino's Pizza because that's how high we were. We forgot Domino's delivers pizza. So we show up to this Domino's. It's like 2 in the morning. There's only 4 people in the place. There's me, Andre, the Domino's employee who's standing behind 6 inches of bulletproof glass. And there's one guy sitting at a table by himself. He's got like a gold jacket on, cornrows. He's talking on a sidekick. Me and Andre, we both go up to the counter. We order pizzas. I get a Coca-Cola. And we go and we sit at this metal bench near the front door and we start talking about unicorns or whatever. And after a few minutes, the guy at the table sees us, hangs up his phone, and just starts yelling from across the room. He's just like, yo, money! Yo, money! And me and Andre are just sitting there at this bench like, which one of us is money? So we decide I was money, right? And I get up and I walk over to this guy's table and I'm basically like, hello, I'm Mr. Money. How can I help you this evening? And the guy looks at me and he's like, yo, my man, give me $2. And I was like, oh, okay, well, what do you need $2 for? Because when I'm stoned, I just turn into like a logic monster, you know? And he goes, I need to take the bus. But you have to understand, at the time, the bus in Boston was only 90 cents. So I looked at him and I was like, the bus in Boston's only 90 cents. Sir. And he goes, yeah, I know. Give me $2. And I was like, oh yeah, good point. So I pull out my wallet, I open it up, I look inside and all I have is a $1 bill and a $20 bill. And I don't know what to do. I just stare at my money for half an hour, I think. Finally, I do some arithmetic. I take out the $1 bill. I slide it over to him. He picks it up, looks at me. He's just like, yo, what the fuck is this? And I was like, that is a dollar. That's enough to take the bus. So have fun on the bus. He starts shaking his head. He's like, yo, I don't think you heard me. I said, give me $2. And I was like, yeah, no, I definitely heard you. You see, the thing is I only have a $1 bill and a $20 bill. So you can understand the conundrum there, because I can't just give you $20. It's not like you have change. Because if you had change for $20, then you would already have $2. So why would you ask me for two more dollars? That's just weird and redundant. He starts nodding his head and he goes, okay, give me $20. And I was like, yeah, you should have just said that. I pull my wallet out again. I take out the $20 bill. I slide it over to him. And then as I do, I go and I reach for my $1 bill to get that back. But he wouldn't allow it. He grabbed it. He had all my money. I'm standing there at the edge of this table staring at him because there was no closure, you know? I didn't know if he needed my watch for the bus too or whatever. I'm standing there, I'm so high, I'm so scared, I am so thirsty. I look down, in my hand I'm holding 20 ounces of Coca-Cola, right? I'm like, oh, thank you, Lord. And I slowly, crazy, never breaking eye contact with this guy, I open my Coca-Cola and just start gulping from it. And with each gulp, I can see in his eyes, he's just getting angrier and angrier at me. Finally, he gets up, gets right in my face, and he goes, you better not drink that Coke outside, motherfucker! And I just immediately snarf all over myself. I just cough up Coke, it's coming out my nose, I'm drooling, I'm like shaking, I'm like, what? What does that mean? What does that mean? Is that a threat? Are you threatening me? I have no idea what's happening right now. He shakes his head, he points outside to where it's snowing, and he's just like, nah, dog. Nah, it's way too cold outside to be drinking soda pop. You're gonna get sick. And then he zipped up his coat and just left with all my money. And I was standing there frozen, just like, what the fuck just happened? I think I just paid $21 to go to the world's scariest health clinic. Bitch face. I turn around, I look at my friend Andre, who was just staring at the menu, didn't see any of it. I was like, hey, thanks, man. Thanks for having my back. That guy just mugged me, I think. I don't know what that was. But then I got all assertive. I was like, let's call the cops. I'm gonna call the cops and get my money back. My friend Andre is like calming me down. He's like, no, man, we can't call the cops. I have a bong in my backpack, so we can't do that. And then I realized he was right, because like, what would happen if we called the cops? They would show up to this Domino's at 2:30 in the morning, demand to see the surveillance tape. It would just be grainy black and white footage of me getting up, walking over to this dude's table, handing him all my money, and then barfing on myself.
LaCroix boys, baby.
Mandy mixtape.